We've all got those half-started, half-finished, but full of unrealized potential apps just lying around. This week, FlutterFlow gave me a reason to dig out one of my old apps, thanks to the new AI Agent Builder feature. So let me show you how easy it is to give your app a new lease on life, thanks to AI Agents.
Let's build. Let's build. Let's build. Let's build.
Let's build. So here we have this old app of mine called NutriScan. Its original purpose was to allow users to scan a barcode and it would get the nutritional information from the wonderful Open Food Facts API. But back in the early days of ChatGPT, I started building out this food camera screen that allowed users to take a photo of a plate of food and have AI estimate the nutritional content contained within it. It was probably only 12 months ago, but AI models have come a long way since then. So with the introduction of the AI Agent Builder feature in FlutterFlow, it was time to relook at this feature. So let's build one from scratch. We're in the AI Agent Builder screen, and we've just created a new agent called Food Camera. The first thing you'll want to do is give your model an internal description. This is really just for you, your team. It will be included in the code, but not shown to your end users. Your system message is where all of your important information needs to go. And here I'm writing that our agent is a nutritional support agent. It'll be given an image and has been asked to look for the food items within it. Itemize them and provide the total nutritional content within them. And I've given it a JSON schema that I'd like it to respond in. This data type is a custom data type that I've set up in the data type screen. This particular data type format corresponds to the way that Open Food Facts structure their nutritional information. So I'm able to merge those data sources in together easily without having any nasty conflicts. Over on the right, we have the model settings. All of the latest AI models from Google, Anthropic, and OpenAI are here, and we're adding more all the time. The model I'm choosing is Gemini because it will accept an image and return JSON. Different models have different capabilities. A few things here. Firstly, we're in the age of multimodal AI agents that can be given an image, text, audio, and even video, and can reply in just as varied modes. Here, I'm giving it an image, and I'm asking it to reply in JSON, in a structured output format. Now, to use the Gemini models, your project must be connected to Firebase, you must have Firebase authentication enabled, and Vertex AI has to be enabled in your Firebase project. If those three things are all correct, the last thing to do is hit publish. Next, we're here on our calorie camera screen. When I click the floating action button, I want the camera to pop up and our user to either take a photo or select one from their gallery. We'll make the upload type a local upload, so it just stores it to our phone's device memory. We'll let the user choose either camera or gallery. We'll do a little downsampling of image quality just to make sure that we don't have ginormous images on our hands. We'll have FlutterFlow provide us with the media dimensions and blur hash, which we may use later on. And we'll show the snack bar to give the user feedback about what's happening in the process. Then below that, we'll add in our new AI agent node. And there's two options to choose from. We can either send the message or clear the chat history. The The conversation ID keeps track of the user's conversation in its current session. And there's a lot of different ways you can set this. I'm not that worried about the agent having the full context of the message history in this instance. So I'm just going to set it as the current time, which means that every time that we go to the agent, it'll be a fresh conversation each time. And for this use case, that's probably fine. We need to just give it a little text input, even though we are providing it an image predominantly. And then we provide the image input from the uploaded image file that we've stored in the previous node. And that comes from widget state, uploaded local file. We'll give this action's output a name. And then we'll save our captured image to a page state variable. Next, I have a custom dialogue that I want to pop up. It's a standard nutritional panel. So I'm adding in the custom dialogue action. This component will take the product data type, which is a custom data type that I've set up in the data type screen. And it matches the JSON format I've asked our Gemini agent to respond in. This comes from the output of our AI agent node. And because our AI agent is outputting JSON and our JSON we've defined as a custom data type already in FlutterFlow, we can pass it straight to that data type and access each field further on in our project. This dialog also takes the captured image, which comes from the widget state. And with that, I think we're ready to see the results. You can see our AI agents in action by downloading NutriScan on the App Store. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe. Thanks for watching and happy building. Let's build.